Hi, so today we are talking about shoulder pain. I'm going to tell you why it happens and what you can do about it. And if you want to jump straight to exercises for that shoulder, you can click the link above or just wait to the end of this video and I'll link you directly to my shoulder pain exercise routine. So let's talk about why shoulder pain happens. There obviously can be many different reasons, but I'm going to talk you through the most common and what you can do about it. You've probably heard the diagnosis impingement tendonitis, bursitis, inflammation, right? All of those can happen in the shoulder, even rotator cuff tendonitis, and they all stem from the same issue. So what happens is you'll get inflammation in the shoulder joint. Now, the shoulder joint itself is a very small area. Things move perfectly in a perfect world to keep things from pinching and causing you pain. So for example, when I lift my shoulder to about 30 degrees, nothing else up in the scapula and the shoulder blade moves. Once I get past 30 degrees, my scapula starts moving. It gets the acromion and the clavicle out of the way. It basically creates space for all these other structures. As I lift my arm, it's this perfect rhythm that happens so that nothing pinches, nothing causes pain, and that you can work efficiently. When we have a poor movement pattern or we get an injury and get inflammation, that suddenly isn't working smoothly anymore and things pinch and cause pain. So I'll give you an example. Let's say you do fall on an outstretched arm and you cause some tendonitis or some inflammation in your rotator cuff tendon. All is fine and good if you could just rest and let it heal. Typically, we can't. So we sometimes develop these movement patterns to get away from the pain, which can cause problems long term. So what happens now is I try to lift my shoulder and it pinches and it hurts. So tell me if this looks familiar, that you lift your arm and you say, ah, that kind of hurts, but if I kind of do this and then up and then I can lift my arm all the way without pain, right? I'm guessing a lot of you are saying, yes, that's me. That is because what you're doing is you're helping to try to get structures out of the way so that it doesn't pinch and hurt when you lift your arm. It's called a painful arc. Okay, same kind of when your arm goes back, a lot of times it'll hurt when you try to take your shirt off like this, when you reach behind the seat in the car or to do your seatbelt. All of those things can cause that kind of pinching in the shoulder, okay? So that's what's happening, is you're constantly kind of pinching down on structures, causing inflammation, causing pain in the tendon itself, sometimes in the bursa, but that's what we mean by that itis, right? Tendonitis, bursitis, it's an inflammation. We treat them the same in physical therapy. So from a physical therapy standpoint, what I want to do is I want to restore that proper movement pattern. I want to get rid of inflammation and I want to allow you to have the best strength you can in your shoulder without this coming back. Because many times this can be a chronic issue with people if they never address why it's happening to start with. So let's talk about what we do about it. Again, from a physical therapy perspective, what I want to do is I want to work on getting that shoulder back where it needs to be in a perfect world. Because what we tend to do that doesn't help us in those pain places is we end up being even more rounded forward, right? We're either sitting in the car all day, on the phone, on the computer, holding our newborn baby, pushing a stroller, anything like that. And the more rounded we are, you can see, the more it's going to pinch down on those structures in the front, causing more problems. I get really weak back here in my rotator cuff and my kind of scapular stabilizing muscles. I get really tight in my pecs. So what we need to do is actually strengthen these muscles back here, open up the front of the shoulder so that suddenly I have more space. And by doing that, what it does is it allows that inflammation to go down. It allows the shoulder to move more freely. It gets you stronger in the muscles you need to be stronger in to support your shoulder girdle. All right. The other piece to it is making sure that that upper spine is really mobile. So you'll see in a lot of my exercise routines and what I give to clients is making sure that thoracic spine is moving because it also tends to get really tight. This can happen to anyone, but again, I see it a lot in people who either have previous injuries they never dealt with, a lot of times in upper back tightness with that poor posture kind of issue. We see it actually quite a bit in people who jump into yoga just because some of those chaturanga postures can cause that rounding forward position. It can happen in the strongest of people, okay? You can bench press 200 pounds, but if you're not doing what you need to balance that and get the shoulder back, then you can get bursitis, impingement tendonitis, all of those issues in the shoulder, okay? So what we do, like I said, is I work on strengthening up here. We do a lot with a TheraBand, a lot to strengthen the rotator cuff. We're gonna open up and stretch out the pecs. Okay, so what I want you to do is start thinking about that posture issue, about really trying to stay strong in the upper back. I also have a 5-minute upper back strengthening routine I really recommend for my clients who have these issues, along with making sure that you're doing lat pull downs, rows, those kind of things if you're going to the gym. So keep that upper back and that rotator cuff really strong. Keep this open and nice posture, and you are going to help your situation with your shoulder. Okay. So again, you can go ahead and go to my shoulder pain routine. I also recommend my upper back strengthening routine. If you do want to learn more, I do virtual consults. So feel free to go to the link below for that. And I hope your shoulder feels better soon. Thanks so much for stopping by. Remember, subscribe to my channel and you'll be notified every time a new video comes up. Like and comment on this video and let me know what you thought. You can also always come over to jessicavalantpilates.com to find all the resources I have for living a healthy lifestyle, including full-length workout videos, healthy recipes, and a community I would love for you to be a part of. So I'll see you there.